Good morning, everyone, and welcome to your Friday teen yoga practice. My name is Sara, and today I'm going to be offering a slightly different practice to usual, only because I've hurt my shoulder and my knee and a couple of other bits and pieces this week. So I'm going to be offering a yoga nidra this week rather than a physical practice. So if you are looking to get moving this morning, perhaps re-watch one of the earlier practices in the week and then add this one on after as your relaxation. So for those of you who've not practiced yoga nidra before, it's a guided meditation and deep relaxation practice. All you need for it is somewhere that you can sit or lie down comfortably. The position is entirely up to you. Normally we recommend practicing in shavasana, perhaps with a light blanket over the top of us just to keep us warm. But however feels comfortable for you is absolutely fine. So you could be sitting in a chair, you could have your legs resting up against the wall or against a sofa or something like that. Just something that allows you to stay in a sustainable position, because you're going to be staying still for a little while today. So it's going to be a slightly shorter practice than normal. I'm only going to go for about 20 minutes for those of you who are new to this relaxation, because it can feel like a little bit strange the first time that you do it. And just to make you aware, if you have ever suffered from psychosis or from trauma, this is probably not the practice for you, so probably one for you to skip today. Generally, yoga nidra can help us sleep. It can help us feel more relaxed, more rested. Sometimes it can bring up things that have happened in the past, so perhaps unpleasant memories or unpleasant experiences. So I need to make you aware of that as well. Hopefully everything you experience today will be lovely and deeply relaxing, because that really is the true idea behind yoga nidra. So when you're ready, just finding a comfortable position for yourself. So either lying down or a comfortable seated position. You might want to just pop a light blanket over the top just to keep you warm, because your body temperature generally does drop a little bit when you've been still for a while. And then when you're ready, just allowing the body to become still. See if you can move away from the fidgeting, twitching, the need to scratch your nose, your face, any other part of the body that suddenly becomes itchy the moment you stop moving. Just paying attention to your surroundings. Paying attention to the space around you, the colours, the quality of the light, any smells that you might notice, sounds that are close to you, or sounds that are far away. And then when you feel ready, allowing your eyelids to close as we begin today's yoga nidra practice. Whatever you experience during the practice is absolutely fine. Thoughts, feelings, sensations may arise, or you may go to sleep. If you do go to sleep, you'll still benefit from the practice. Know that you are able to leave the practice at any time, or return to it if you become disturbed by an uncomfortable thought or feeling, or from a noise outside. If you are disturbed, simply acknowledge the distraction and then continue to follow the sound of my voice. Now when you're ready, begin to bring the awareness into your body. Feel the plane of contact between your body and the floor. The plane of contact between your head and the floor. Plane of contact between your back and the floor. Plane of contact between your legs and the floor. Feel the plane of contact between the body and the floor. Feel that the body is safe, supported, and secure, feeling the plane of contact between the body and the floor. And then bringing your attention to your right thumb, your right index finger, middle finger, ring finger, and little finger. Feel the palm of the right hand, the back of the right hand, feel the wrist, the lower arm, the elbow, the upper arm, the right shoulder, feel the right side of the chest, the right side of the torso, the right hip, top of the right leg, front and back, the right knee, the lower leg, front and back, the right ankle, the top of the right foot, the sole of the right foot, the right big toe, second toe, third toe, fourth toe, and little toe. And feel the whole of the right side of the body, from the toes all the way back up the leg, pelvis, torso, shoulder, down the arm, and back to the right hand. Really feel the right hand. Really feel the right hand. And then bring your awareness to your left thumb, index finger, middle finger, ring finger, and little finger. With the palm of the left hand, back of the left hand, the left wrist, the lower arm, front and back, the left elbow, the upper arm, the left shoulder, the left side of the chest, the left side of the torso, the left hip, top of the left leg, the left knee, the left shin and the left calf, the left ankle, the top of the left foot, the sole of the left foot, the left big toe, second toe, third toe, fourth toe, and little toe, and the whole of the left side of the body, from the toes all the way up the leg, pelvis, the torso, chest, shoulder, down the left arm, and back to the left hand. Really feel the left hand. Really feel the left hand. Then feel both hands together, both wrists, both elbows, both shoulders, the chest, the torso, pelvis, the hips, the top of the legs, the knees, the lower legs, the ankles and the feet. Feeling the whole of the body from the feet all the way back up till you reach the collarbones. And then feel the neck, front and back. And bring awareness to the face, to the mouth, sensations inside the mouth, the tongue, the teeth and the lips. Awareness to your nose, the very tip of your nose, space between the eyebrows, the right eyebrow, the right eye, the left eyebrow, and the left eye, the forehead, the cheeks, the chin, the right ear, the left ear, the whole of the face together, from the crown of the head to the back of the head, from the whole of the head together, and then feel all of your body right from the very top of your head all the way down to the tips of your toes, from the whole body. Whole body from the toes, all the way back up to the crown of the head, feel the whole right side of the body, from the head to the toes, and the whole left side of the body, from the toes to the head. Feel the whole body, feel the whole body. Whole body resting safe, supported and secure. And then when you're ready, begin to bring awareness instead to your breath. Feel the body breathing. Don't try and change your breath, just notice how it feels when you inhale. And when you exhale, and bring awareness to the place just outside the nostrils where the air exchanges, where warm air leaves the body and cool air is drawn in. Bringing awareness to the nostrils, just notice how it feels. When you inhale, and when you exhale, just watching the breath. And this time, when you inhale, see if you can imagine inhaling only with the right nostril. When you exhale, see if you can imagine exhaling only with the left nostril. And then inhaling with the left nostril, exhaling with the right nostril. Inhaling the whole right side of your body. Exhaling with the whole left side of your body. Inhaling with the left side of the body. Exhaling with the right side of the body. as you inhale and exhale in your own time. See if you can continue alternating your breath from the right side to the left side, left side to right side, inhaling and exhaling in your own time. Perhaps see if you can begin counting your breath. As you inhale and exhale, count one, inhale, exhale, count two, counting on and on, and seeing how high a number you can reach, alternating the breath from left to right side, from right to left side. Inhaling and exhaling in your own time. With counting. Left to right side. Right to left side, inhaling and exhaling. And then when you're ready, whatever number you've reached, go of the breath. Let go of the breath and bring the attention to your body once more. See if you can notice that the body has become heavy. Perhaps it's in the hands or the feet. Perhaps in the torso. And notice the sensation. Heaviness. Feel that the body has become very heavy, sinking down into the support of the earth. And then also notice somewhere in the body there may be a feeling of lightness. Perhaps it's within the face. Perhaps the fingertips or the feet, somewhere in the body, see if you can notice a sensation of lightness, floating. And then come back to the heaviness once more, the places in the body that still feel rooted to the earth, sinking down and down, heavy. And then come back to the sensation of lightness. Lightness in the chest, in the face, the hands, the legs. Sensations of light and floating. And see if you can welcome in, at the same time, the sensation of heaviness, so that some parts of the body feel light, and others feel heavy. Welcome in this opposite of sensation. The heaviness and the lightness present in the same body. And then let go of any sensations. And just notice how still the body is now. Noticing any movements within the mind. And if there are thoughts, or emotions, acknowledging them, and then letting them pass on by like clouds on a sunny day. Allowing yourself to sink into the stillness. Allowing the thoughts and the emotions to pass on by, so that you notice that there is still an awareness within the stillness that is more than the thoughts, more than the emotions, and more than just the physical body. There's an awareness within the stillness. And allow yourself just for a moment to be still and to be aware, watching any thoughts, noticing any body sensation, but coming always back to this point of stillness beneath them all. And just resting here a moment, allowing yourself to simply be. Resting in the stillness of awareness. Resting and being. Nothing to think, nothing to feel, nothing to do. Just resting here. And then see if you can become aware of any sensations of light within yourself. Perhaps it's the light from the room that you're in coming through the eyelids. Perhaps there is an imaginary light within your mind. Focusing on the idea of a golden light bathing your entire body, a golden light bathing your body from the crown of the head all the way down to the very tips of the toes, bathed in a warm golden light. And as you feel the light move down the body, perhaps bringing movement back, first into the hands and the arms, then into the legs and the feet, bringing movement back as the light passes over you, bringing movement back into the physical body. We prepare to come back to the waking world. So bringing movement back into the body, to the hands and the arms, the legs and the feet. And then when you're ready, you may like to stretch, or you may like to roll over onto your side. Always the left side. If you have low blood pressure or you're pregnant, and just staying here a moment. And when you're ready, gradually allowing the eyelids to open, acknowledging the space around you, the colours, sounds, smells that are with you in this space. Welcoming back in the waking world as you prepare to carry on with your day. May you be content with what you have. May you rejoice in the way that things are. May you realize that you lack nothing, and may you be always where you're supposed to be. Today's practice of yoga nidra is now over. Namaste. Okay, so taking your time here, you may want to come up slowly. You may want to rest on your side for a little bit longer. You may even want to go back onto your back for a while. Depends how relaxed you're feeling. If that nidra did bring up any unpleasant feelings for you, then just being aware that that might change how you feel today. But hopefully for you, it was a very relaxing and restful practice. So my self-care tip for this week is going to be to respect where your body is on any given day. So if you have injured yourself, like me this week, making sure that you're not pushing into physical practices, making sure that you take time to do what's right for your body on any given day. And that can change from day to day. Okay, it can change, especially if, like me, you're someone who lives with a disability, and that makes your health condition fluctuate. So always respect where your body is today. And my Zen challenge for you this week, I brought some, it's like show and tell when you were at little school. So I have brought a card that my goddaughter made for me. Can you see it? Beautiful. She's very, very little. So she's just learning to play with paint and sticky things. So she made me this. And then a card that my friend made for me. One of her lovely paintings. So I've had two cards this last week just to say hello and just to basically check in and see how I'm doing. So I thought a really nice thing that you could do over the next week for your Zen challenge is to make a card for somebody and send it to them just to see how they are, just to let them know that you're thinking of them. So that is my Zen challenge. As ever, stay safe, stay well, and I will see you again next Friday. Take care. Bye-bye.